happening at the same time that many regions are reporting such incidents at nursing homes. Many families, including mine, are now separated from our elders who are living at senior memory care and assisted living facilities. Per health guidelines, only essential staff are now allowed inside. It's a challenging time.
I'm the primary caregiver for my almost 90-year-old mother. I recently shared this picture on social media of how we now visit, talking on the phone and through the window. This day, she broke down in tears, crying at being separated. It's tough, and I'm not alone.
You know, you feel guilty because they're there and you're home and you can't get there, and the only way you can talk to them is on the phone or Skype.
Cynthia Robinson is now cut off from her husband, Ed, also in facility care. Husband, father, and a former CHP officer, Ed has dementia.
They have memory problems, so Ed, you don't want them to forget who you are. And by not seeing you on a daily basis, that you're afraid they're going to lose more of their memory.
Lori Monaco is in Florida. She, too, is cut off from her father in a VA hospital. He's a World War II vet with failing memory. High-profile cases involving the coronavirus have many on edge about the safety of loved ones.
It's been strained.
In Orlin, Art Leonard worries about his 93-year-old mother, Dolores, also in facility care.
The time of being with Mom that pleases her the most and me is the fact that she, as she's expressed to me, I get to see you, I get to touch you, I get to sit next to you.
No easy answers to balance the health and safety of our elders.
And I would rather he be safe and not have it and not get sick.
And Cynthia says her husband doesn't understand the situation or why her visits have now stopped. He believes that she's simply too busy to make time for him. And what also makes this experience so difficult is not knowing if any members of the care staff could possibly expose family members to the virus.